When you say go too high or go too low, let's give people who are listening or watching this a visual sort of understanding what is too low, what is too high. So let's say what is a high amount, and in which country, for example, they have those amounts, and what kind of people, and what stages of life, and what's too low.
Right. So before I tell you like toxic amounts of vitamin D, let me actually first say that. So toxic levels of vitamin D is above 4,000 IU, and that is through supplementation. Now, there's a funny little paradox here, is that when you look at people, contemporary Africans that live ancestral lifestyles, so they're out in the sun a lot compared to, you know, us, we're sitting inside, there's no sunlight here. They have actually, when we convert it, we test those vitamin D levels, it actually translates into like 6,000 IU. 6,000. So that would be very toxic if you would get that through supplementation. But the reason is because the vitamin D, that's produced in our skin through sun exposure is actually our body can regulate it much, much better.
Because it's natural, right?
Exactly.
Right. So
Yeah.
fake vitamin D ain't good then.
I think in some cases it's still necessary, just because we live in less ideal places on this planet.
Okay.
So, but then you'd have to, and that's why I always say, don't go over 4,000. Never supplement more than 4,000 ever. Like some doctors do that in case of like severe health issues, where there's a severe osteoporosis or etc. But I'm not going to do any recommendations on that. That's up to your doctor,
Physician.
physician. Yes, but for regular people, stay between 2 and 4,000 is the safest, I think. And that is if you are minimally exposed to the sun. And in winter, if you live above 50 degrees latitude, for example, your body's not going to make any vitamin D in winter. So why not take a supplement?
What about, given that pregnant women, they are feeding themselves and the baby. Do they need a different level of vitamin D in their
Yeah,
diet?
that's an excellent point you're making now. And that's because if breastfeeding women, if they would have 6,000 IU, 6,000, then actually that would be sufficient to give babies enough vitamin D. And the funny part is, we are giving most of our babies vitamin D drops. You know, that is not how evolution has, you know, set things up for us to give
Envision
our,
it.
yeah, envision it exactly. So, and that's funny, and that's because moms are generally low on vitamin D. So you need to compensate for that by giving our babies vitamin D drops. Yeah,
Yeah.
but that's funny that 6,000 is enough, and that's the same as the contemporary
But it
Africans I just told you about.
Listen to the entire episode of the Immunity Podcast.
Link in the description below.